I had a friend who did this last year and really enjoyed it. Just seeing the lineup of speakers started to really attract my attention.
I've really been looking forward to learning more, taking a deeper dive into originalism and just learning all the intricacies of it.
I'd always been interested in originalism as a judicial philosophy, and I really wanted to know kind of the nitty-gritty of what it was as a theory. So that was my hope in this boot camp.
We've decided to try to recruit some of the best law students from around the country to come to Georgetown and be exposed to the cutting-edge, state-of-the-art approach to what originalism is and how it should best be practiced.
I definitely didn't really know what originalism was ahead of time, and just getting to hear from so many different originalism positions, not just one vein of originalism.
But it's way thicker and way more rich than I thought. I mean, there's competing theories of what the actual truest form of originalism is. There's competing theories about, you know, what to do with originalism.
I'm someone who's interested in strategic litigation and appellate litigation. That is particularly why I also want to understand how lawyers and judges can use originalism.
I was interested in how to actually practice it. I mean, theory is one thing, but sometimes there's a disconnect between theory and practice.
Our lunch presentation from Justice Lee was fascinating.
He's talking to us about the use of corpus linguistics, which is kind of using like research databases in order to help determine the original public meaning and usage.
We had practitioners, historians, we had a philosopher of law talk about originalism. So I thought that was very useful to hear all these different perspectives.
Without a doubt, the thing that most excited me about the boot camp was getting to meet the Supreme Court justices. I mean, we get to meet Justice Gorsuch, Justice Thomas, and Justice Alito.
Seeing Supreme Court justices is great. I think I'm still a little bit shaky just from all the excitement going in there.
Hearing about how the Supreme Court works behind the scenes and how the justices interact with each other was really interesting.
We are really looking for people we think are going to be the intellectual and practicing movers and shakers in the future.
I've probably never met such an accomplished group of students.
Part of it's intimidating because there's a really good group of people here.
Many, many of our students have done judicial clerkships or are going to be doing judicial clerkships, so they will actually be assisting judges in writing opinions, and their knowledge of originalism could come in handy when that happens.
I would like to clerk, and I think all the tools that we're given here will help to enable me to do a good job for my judge.
Understanding how to read the Constitution is a really basic part of being a successful clerk. So having a clear theory of how to interpret the Constitution, I think, will benefit me.
All in all, I feel like I have a much better grounding in what originalism really is, both the theory and the practical application, as well as some of the newer developments, the array of speakers and everything that we had. Leaves me feeling much more confident in what I do know about originalism, but also inspired to learn more.